maneuver. Oops, that was time warping. And I could, because I've played the game and I understand the basic concepts, I could get a Duna encounter here. Let's just go ahead and set that as a target. Let's do this. That is not going to be right at all. I know that Duna is in a higher orbit than me, and if I want to get to it, I want to eject myself from Kerbin Prograde, right? So I would come over here, and I would find where Prograde is, and I would pull until I get an ejection from Kerbin, like that. And then I would move the node around until I eject myself roughly like that. And that right there is going to put me in that higher orbit, right? That is going to get me on a slightly sort of home and transfer because I understand the basic concepts. I can put a little bit less in. Let's see here. The game right now is telling me that when I get there, Duna's going to be right there. That's not a good thing. That means that it's not the right time to do, so I'm going to need to wait some amount of time before we actually do this. Kill the node. I'm not going to kill the node. So could I do anything to actually get this? I know I'm not getting there soon enough, so I need to cut to the inside of the solar system. If I need to cut a little bit to the inside of the solar system, I could actually come over here and... let's zoom in some more. There we go. I could come over here and cut to the inside a little bit, right, like that, right? And now that I'm not ejecting exactly programmed, I'm cutting to the inside a little bit. That should allow me to spin more Delta V and get there a little faster. That's not cutting in nearly enough, so I would come back over here, and I would do that cutting to the inside, right? This is going to cost me a lot more Delta V. But now I could do this, and that should get me a little bit closer. Not exactly. Let's do a little bit more Delta V. We're going to need more to get there sooner, because it's not the right time to do the transfer. So now I'm going to be right there. It's going to be right there. Let's zoom back in again. And we can just keep playing with this. Let's see here. There we go. You can see it in the background getting closer and closer, but it's going to take a whole lot of Delta V to get that encounter done. It is not the right time right now. Let's put about 2,000 in. Whoa! Boom! Jeez, oh Pete. Wall of text. Much more efficient. Thanks for the tutorial. Yeah, that's the way you've been doing it. Yep, that's exactly. It is much more efficient. A lot of times you can get on the first try. Let me just go for 2,000 meters a second of Delta V here. That's a lot. And then we could do this sort of thing. Where is Duna going to be? I don't see Duna. There it is. Okay. Now that I've got eyes on both of it. There we go. Oh, it was behind the sun. Of course it's going to be behind the sun. There's the Duna encounter right there. So now you see we have that really close encounter. 83 million kilometers. I could tweak this a little bit to see if I can't get the encounter. Nope. And there you go. There's a Duna encounter using 1900 meters per second of Delta V. So, understanding the basic concepts, right? Cutting on the inside of the orbit, spending more Delta V, getting there faster. Can I get an encounter with Duna? Yes. Could I sit there and wait? Could I look at the transfer angles and look at the relative angles between the planets and wait for the right time, the planetary alignment, and then do the ejection? Sure, I could do all that without using the mod, I could just use a raw reference sheet because I understand the basic concepts. Am I going to sit here and stream how to do it? Maybe some people would be interested in that. I don't know. Maybe some people would be interested, but in terms of the mod computing it for you, I don't think that that's cheaty at all. I don't think that it's cheaty at all. As long as you make an effort to understand the basic concepts, or not, just play the game. Who cares? Have fun. Who cares? Have fun. Let's see here. Did I miss anything else? We got that. We got that. Sayoung Mi, I think I took care of you. Let me scroll through the chat and see if I missed any questions. That Duna encounter is more than we can afford. Do you get any bonus boost by leaving the orbit in the direction the world spins? No. If you're already in orbit, it doesn't matter. Just you're a sunk cost at that point, right? You're a sunk cost. You're already in orbit. It doesn't matter if you're prograde or retrograde. This is very important, though. However, this is very important. Look. What you do want to do, if you're in the Kerbin system, look at that. Look at that ejection angle, right? We're ejecting basically straight to the inside. What we could do here, if we were in orbit around the moon, I would not want to eject to Duna when the moon was on retrograde, when the moon was moving retrograde to Kerbin's orbit. I would want to eject from the moon when the moon was moving prograde. That would allow me to add the moon's 542, come on, 542 meters per second of orbital velocity. On this side, it would subtract it from my ejection delta V, and on this side, it would add it to my ejection delta V. You see some people get in a hurry sometimes, and they eject at the wrong time. The orbit of the moon can actually add or subtract to your ejection delta V. How difficult is a free return outside the Kerbin system? Agliability, what do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? I don't know what you're talking about. Let's see here. I don't understand that question. A free return outside the Kerbin system. Outside the Kerbin system. What do you mean by that? Did you get that, Deep in the Batter? If I eject from here, the moon is orbiting this way. And if I want to eject that way, and I do it from there, I'm going to have to overcome the moon's retrograde motion in order to get out of there. If I do it there, I'm going to add the moon's prograde motion. Anti-retrograde motion. Yes. Can I make something else? I'm making all sorts of stuff right now. Like a straight shot to Joule and back to Kerbin without adjusting. Agliability, I'm not going to say that that's impossible, but I'm going to say that that would be very, very difficult to do. That would be very, very difficult to do without adjusting anything the entire way. That would be very, very, very difficult to plot, plan, and do everything on, man. That would be a very difficult thing to do. It would totally be possible. I'm not even sure. Artek, it would be possible if you don't get into orbit around Joule. If you don't go into orbit around Joule, you couldn't go to Joule and go into orbit around Joule and then get out of Joule without burning, ever, I don't think. But, well, you could. You could set up an elliptical orbit that eventually encountered a moon. Anyways. Let me get caught up with chat right quick. Let me see if I missed any other questions. And I really do appreciate everybody watching. I appreciate people hanging out with me. I know that I'm not building and crashing rockets and that sort of stuff right now. Work on the propeller thing. Yes, Dragon Slayer, I am going to work on that. Whoa, there was one. Cy Young Mi! Thanks for being an amazing teacher. Happy holidays and Mountain Dew rules. Dude, I'll allow it. I'll allow it. Every man has a price. Me saying Mountain Dew rules as I'm reading it as it was typed in your thing. $25, I'll say Mountain Dew rules on my channel. You're exactly right. Dekus Mara, you're exactly right. KSP doesn't make it easy to plan those very precise maneuvers. You're exactly right. Sign me, dude. That's a serious donation. I really do appreciate it. I really do appreciate it. I hope I answered all your questions, man. That's totally not how it works. You don't have to give a donation just because I answer a question, but I really do appreciate the support. I really do appreciate the support. I have a lot of fun doing it. And the support like that makes it so I can keep doing this every day. It's likely you will still cross Kerbin's orbit, so you will eventually hit Kerbin. Yeah, you're right. Yes. Not without adjusting at all, but slingshine around the dark side of Joule and back to Kerbin without major burns. Yeah, but it makes it very difficult to do that. Wait, there was no exclamation point in there. And I was reading what Cy Young Mi put. I was reading what Cy Young Mi put in the donation note. Thanks for being an amazing teacher. Happy holidays. Parentheses open. And Mountain Dew rules. Mountain Dew rules. I don't even know what I just said. Mountain Dew rules. Anyways. Okay. I'm going to scroll through the chat, guys. Let me go into screensaver mode. I am going to continue work on this. We'll leave the Dr. Pepper can up there. Wait, what? Dant Dog, is there any instance that launching the rocket with rotation of Kerbin has any benefits? Orbiting Kerbin, we always launch. We always launch in the direction of the rotation so we can add the rotational speed to our orbital velocity. The other thing... I mean, certainly if you need a rendezvous with an asteroid that's coming in a retrograde orbit, you would want to launch into a retrograde orbit. You would also maybe want to, if you had a curve, something stranded or whatever. There are some lunar encounters, I believe you can get some specific lunar encounters by going retrograde. Oh, there we go, Cy Young Mi. I've learned so much from your streams and YouTube DOS and enjoyed all the craziness. Always happy to support. Thank you, Cy Young Mi. I really do appreciate it. Yes, it is censored on DOS's channel. You're right. That's right. I am totally a soda racist. I am not unhappy to say that I am a soda racist. It's all in good fun. Whoa, there's another one. Agliability, dude. Couple of party pizzas on me. Thanks, bruh. Thank you. I appreciate it, dude. I will totally get a party pizza on you. Actually, On Friday, when I do my stream on Friday, I totally accept pizza donations. If people give me a donation, I totally order pizzas on Friday and then I eat them on stream because I totally appreciate it. Dude, Derpinator, Juliappy, Juulappy, Senor Mole, thanks for the follows. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Agliability, thank you for the support. Siyoungmi, thank you for the support. I do appreciate it, guys. Crazy, you need crazy. It's important to share the Dr. Pepper with the entire Kerbal Galaxy. Yes. Alright, let me go on back to the Space Center. DOS is prejudice against all drinks that don't have PhDs. We need miniature, we need wee bitty jet engines. So chat. Should I continue working on the SAS approach? Or should I not? Should I just go with rocket engines? Because, where was it? Games with Hank said rocket-powered. He totally said rocket-powered. He was trying to make a rocket-powered helicopter. My donation is going for Dr. P. Dispute the charge! Dispute the charge with PayPal! Okay, let's see here. Should I keep going with the... Okay, I should keep going with this. Let's try this. We've thrust limited these enough. That's 50% thrust. Let's see where we're going. Get to the SAS chopper! He normally does use liquid fuel tanks. You mean he hasn't done this yet? He hasn't accomplished this yet? What is his... what's his mission parameter? I know he's gone by now. He totally, like, tweeted me out earlier and stuff. I really do appreciate what he was doing for me earlier. Let me see how this works. As soon as you start rotating off, I need like another hand to do this. It's like a boomerang. All right. Is enough ejects? It should be. No, it totally should be. Let me try it one more time and let's see what our problems are. No, Hank Green tweeted me out earlier. Hank Green totally tweeted. Was that? That's Hank Green, right? Yeah, Games with Hank tweeted me out earlier, which is freaking nuts. I mean, I really did appreciate what he was doing for me earlier. There's a company that tried to do it for real. Nice. All right, let's try this again. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's do that. We're gonna rotate. I'm gonna panel lock. This should be more than enough electric charge. Yeah, see, my electric charge is not going down. You would have to constantly fly it. You totally have to constantly fly it. Am I hovering? What's my vertical speed? I can't look. I've got to fly the thing. Negative. It's negative right now. And it always goes into this sort of shit. I don't have enough fingers to do this. I totally don't have enough fingers to do that. You set the trim on your rotation so you don't have to hold a button anymore. Oh, hell yeah, that makes sense. Putting SAS wheels on the outer edge of the wings? I'm not sure if that would work. Huh. It just doesn't have enough torque. Twinter, I think you're right. I just don't think that it I made a kaboomerang. Nice. I don't think that it has enough torque. So I think we're just going to go with... it's a nice parachute you have here. Teflon Mike. Dude, what's going on, Teflon? What's going on, Teflon? It's because you're flying an inverted pendulum. Do you think so, though? I don't actually know if that's going to be the case. Can you go with eight wings? I could go with eight wings. I don't... At some point, I'll try eight wings. Okay, I can go with eight wings. I will also, tomorrow's Thursday. Epic Studios, it's coming up pretty soon. I don't have enough fingers to do this. yes. Took so long to create in real life. Dang, cryoscopic procession? I don't know what that means. Alright. Let me see here. Oh no. That's gonna be a problem. Alright, let me take that off. Let me take that off. Let me put that like that. I'm gonna have to restack this entire thing. That's okay, we can do it. Won't take long. I'll put it on the bottom and we'll see if... I think the same thing's actually going to happen. I don't think that it has anything to do with that. I know it makes good sense, but I don't think that that's our problem here. That should be gyroscopic. I gotcha. Replace the 3 wide with 4 of the 1 meter part ones and reduce the number of RTGs. Those things are heavy. I think but the mass fraction of those is probably pretty... We could maybe do that. I don't know. Let's see here. Mountain Dew rules. No! No! Nobody... That's not a quote. That's not a quote. Let's see here. Okay, let's see if this tries. Let's see if this works. I'm gonna go ahead and throttle up Panel Lock SES Engage. 3, 2, 1, do the thing with the stuff by putting a new stage in. Like that. Okay. See, it doesn't make a difference. As soon as I get off of it, I start to go sideways again, and I think it's something to do with the fact that I'm, yeah, I'm totally falling down again. So see, it doesn't have anything to do with the center of lift versus the center of mass. I know that makes good sense, but from experience, I don't think that would really do it. It's just flying, you know? Whoa, 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 whoa! We hit the fuel lines, it looks like. Oh my gosh. Undead Beast Guy! It's gonna need a kickstand. Alright. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Yeah, exactly! Exactly! See, I'm gonna fly through the blades. That would be the problem. A swash plate! Yes, I do need a swash plate. You are correct. I don't have a swash plate. I don't think that I could make a swash plate in stock KSC. Yeah, I'd have to fly through it. That's why I put it on top. Use the large boosters. And just thrust limit them way down. I could do that. Just make them long, go for longer. But see, I'm going to have to fly through it. That's why I had it on top. And that didn't really give us any more stability. That didn't really give us any more stability, putting the payload on the bottom like that. I didn't think it was going to, because it makes good real-world common sense, but it doesn't make KSP sense. What am I looking for? There you go. All right, so if I put this thrust, like, way down, like this... Like way down. Those should burn for a while, I think, right? Let's see how this works. Smaller SAS. Swash plate, yep. How are you going to go to the second stage? I know. I know. Oh, you were kidding about it. Try adding more weight to the bottom and try that. But that's not going to work. This is going to work. This is going to work right here. Hang on. Time out, y'all. So what's the design requirement? Am I trying to get it to, the free Rototron from Iowa would make it possible. Yeah. Stick up a wing piece perpendicular at the ends of arms. It would seem to generate more lift. Really? This is going to be good. It's not even like straight up. Let's just try it. It just fell apart. It just fell apart. Hang on. I just didn't launch it fast enough. You only have... After you roll it out to the pad, you only have a few seconds to launch it. It's just like... All right. Physics engage. Well, payload's intact. Still spins. Oh, that's not intact, apparently. Still goes to space. Oh my gosh. Too many makes KSP too... Recomone, I agree. Too many mods makes me very, too many mods makes me very, very, very just tired, honestly. It's just too many parts to go through sometimes, you know? Will the struts reach? The struts will not reach. And I can't do it once I've been in symmetry. Alright, this is totally gonna work, y'all. Seems legit. Alright, like that? And I think I need to unthrust limit a little bit. I need like 15% thrust maybe. We probably need a launch clamp as well. Oh, it got up to that amount of working as intended. Add a ton of struts. Okay. Okay, I think we can go with a much easier design. 4,500 meters. Okay. Wait, what is? This is exactly what he did? Because I don't know what he did. I'm unimpressed by this so far. It's gonna rip our engine off. That's not looking good, honestly. That is not looking good at all. Uh-oh. It's just a death Ferris wheel. Alright. Look at that. So those things just weigh too much. You need to walk kerbals into it. Oh my gosh. You should, pro gamers, you should laugh. I'm laughing too, man. I can't believe it's still on that engine. It's gonna rotate. Oh, it's flying! It's totally flying! It's hovering like a champ! I'm actually increasing. I'm actually taking off. Look at this. I'm up to 1 meter per second now. The amazing thing is that I'm not actually touching any buttons. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, look at this thing. Look at it go! Oh, totally highlight worthy, the Rectcopter, nice. It is, dreidel, dreidel, dreidel. I made you out of clay. We're actually up to 5 meters per second. That's amazing that we're up to 5 meters per second. You know what this is telling me? More thrust. More thrust. More thrust. Stream time. The stream time is currently 12:29. So the stream time here is going to be, we started at 8, so basically four and a half hours. 4.5 hours. No, we can increase the thrust. We needed rate of spin. Because it's the rate of spin versus the, It's totally going up. Look at it. That's amazing. Zonic Mega, I don't want to tilt the SRBs. If you want to angle... No, I don't want to do that. I don't want to angle them. I only want the lift to come from the wings. What is the rate of spin right now? We're up to 16, 17 meters per second. It looks like a cotton dispenser. Uh-oh. It's time for us to stage. Can we make it through? Hang on, we've got to turn a little bit. No, we didn't make it through. Wait, we're still flying. We're not done. What? How did that work? I crashed into it. I didn't explode at all. Something that exploded. What just happened? What just happened? I don't understand what just happened. I have no clue what just happened. Oh my gosh. And I probably still have enough Delta V to go to space, which is amazing. Let's go back to the VAB. Oh my gosh. The propellers were the ejection system. I don't even know what crashed. You killed some of the I probably just crashed off that. I wonder if we took more or if we took less weight. Let's take less weight. Let's not even take that thing. I know it doesn't weigh much, does it? How much does that thing weigh? 0.08. I mean, it counts. And then what if we take the SAS off the top? I almost need the SAS at the top. Let's just put a... We're barely even using these things. So let's just put one of them, right? All right. You blew up the decoupler is all. You need jet engines with thrust limiting and fuel in the core. Yes, T-Game. I think that is where we're going to end up. I think that's where we're going to end up. Oh, my gosh. That was freaking nuts. Turn into a dreidel. I think we're going to be okay. Hoping it can fly up through the helicopter blades probably isn't good planning. We could just make it blow apart. We could make all the blades fly off, and then we could fly past it, right? Smaller SAS, add 2 steps just to jump it into the air. We could rotate it to the side and fly past it. That could be a thing. Kerbal Catherine Wheel. Teflon might get you some... Or maybe don't get you some sleep. Do whatever it is you're going to do. Look, I'm going to double the thrust. Epic Studios, Mark. Thanks for the follow. Also, Indy Brown, I think I missed you earlier. Thank you for the follow as well. Let's see what we're going to do. He'd get it right if it had a better angle of attack and the booster stayed at the same rotation. Stayed at the same rotation. You mean just had... I think the better angle of attack is going to kill us, honestly. So that's a thing, apparently. Is going to sleep. Okay, gotcha. Take it easy, man. Put wings on the decouplers so when you stage, they fly away. Yes, Jack is scared. That's exactly what I was thinking. That's exactly what I was thinking, honestly. Do 100% thrust. I don't think I need that. I just need to launch sooner. What's up, Riding? How's it going, man? Mobius Prolix. I appreciate the follow. Progress. All right. It's the weight. It's the weight of the SRBs. There! I'm taking off! I'm totally taking off! Oh my goodness! That wasn't good. What blew up? Epic Studios, Mark, get you some sleep. What blew up? Structural failures between advance and the stack decoupler. Oh! Okay, we need to, Alright. Put the launch escape, then activate it. Ooh, that thing weighs so much, though. It weighs so much. It really does weigh so much. The launch escape system weighs a few tons. Oh, my gosh. What's frustrating? Aw, dude, Riding, don't worry about it. You're hanging out with us now. If your day was frustrating, turn that frown upside down. We're freaking making helicopters to go into space. There, that's what we need. Too much power! Reentry is kind of easy and it flies great. You're not talking about this craft, clearly. Hey. Come on. Come on. Look, we could totally do this. Does this seem legit? F3 is the screen that comes up and tells you what went wrong. Yeah, dude, Riding, hang out with us, man. We're having fun. We're freaking making a freaking copter mabobber thingy. Oh my gosh. Oh, wait a second. That's the same thing he's doing. I should do something different. To auto-rotate a landing. Yes, that would be amazing, Sayoung-mi. That would be amazing. Auto-rotation would be difficult because I don't have pitch control, though. I don't have pitch control. Now it just needs guns. Let's do this. Let's see how this goes. I think I'm going to die. See? Yeah, that's not gonna work. That's definitely not gonna work. I see a flaw. I totally see the flaw. That's just gonna make an impact. Yeah, that's not gonna work. That's not gonna work. Yeah, because he asked. He asked the question, could we make a helicopter as a launch pad? So I'm having fun with it. I know that it's been done before, and I usually don't do things that have been done before on my stream, but He asked, and he totally was really cool to me earlier. I felt really rude because I didn't know who he was, and I really appreciated it. I mean, I really did, so I'm having some fun with this. I am definitely having fun with this. The clamps laughed. All right. That is exactly what we're doing. Total water takeoff craft. I call it perfection. All right. I don't have enough... I have to be pointing up. Wow, if you don't take off soon, that thing is just not happy. You have to take off so soon. You seriously have to take off so soon. Alright. You've got to get that spin stabilization going very quickly. There we go. Now we're taking off. Does the grapple rotate? The grapple won't rotate like that, no. The grapple won't rotate like that. Let's get it to space and recreate the interstellar docking schemes. Alright, alright. That was a problem. Shortening the wings by one unit might help with stability. Yeah, probably so. Launch times to the sides instead of the bottom. The wings took off. So that amount of rotation is too much. That amount of rotation is too much. I think it's the physics lag. I think it is the physics lag. What are we at? 4,000? I mean, we should just go for like a blender type design, right? We should probably just go for this sort of design. Look. We're just gonna make a jet engine, basically. That is gonna push against the other engine. It's not gonna have enough clearance. Oh, maybe not. It may just barely be clearing it. Seems legit. Totally hashtag seems legit, y'all. That looks so legitimate. I don't even know what to say about it other than the fact that it's legit. More pitch, less rotation. Valor, we'll give that a try next. We'll give that a try next. All right. I wonder if this is going to be enough. It's kind of shredded. It's kind of not shredded. Let's go back to less rotation. Because now we also have more lift. Let's try this. That looks like it'll work. That seems legit. Everyone pray. Pray on what? What do you want people to pray on? That was sad. That was sad. That one fell over too quickly. Let me see if I just didn't get it fast enough. Your wings are not angled. Oh, wait. My other... Oh, they're not. You're right. They're not angled. Thank you for that, by the way. Government work. Hashtag government work. Alright. Those wings are angled, but these wings are not angled. There. So legitimate. That's just freaking crazy. What are the wings lift versus weight? Yeah, you're right. Let's try this. Keep it classy in my channel as well, please. It's like a biplane. It's totally a biplane design. Let's see how this works. Is this gonna work? I think it's gonna work. Alright. I'm pretty sure this isn't gonna work. What can you do though? I need some way to like instantly... Oh my gosh. I totally need some way to just like instantly do this. We're losing sight with more wings, more struts, more wings. I think we're okay though. I think I just lost a wing. Alright, we don't have a way to, wing spinning, we can't do wing spinning in opposite directions. Huh. I wonder. I wonder. I wonder. We're just not getting enough spin. We need some way to stay up. We totally need some way to stay up. Maybe we could do something like this. Look. If you did landing gear, would you not have to worry about going instantly? You turned on RCS, not... Oh, I did. I turned on RCS, not SAS. My bad. All right. I think that this is what we're going to do. Just because... Alright, see, look how legitimate that looks. And then we could totally do this sort of shenaniganry. And then we could totally do this. Is that gonna give us the clearance? Hashtag seems legit, let's go. You had it with 15 on thrust in the saw sides. You're right, I did have it earlier. More rotation for less fuel. Yeah, but then they'll hit each other. You don't have as much room. They don't have as much room. Alright, I don't see how this could possibly fail. I don't want to angle the rockets. That's cheating. Okay. But I actually need to launch the SRBs first. Okay, there we go. In before it catches the edge. Oh, is it bigger than the edge? No, that's not gonna work if it's bigger than the edge. Oh man, I've gotta put them closer to this into the center. Oh no, we're good. Why is it doing that? It's about to just jump off the launch pad. I don't even know what just happened there. Stack decoupler. Oh, the, they're dancing to the chiptunes. This is too much fun. This really is a lot of fun, yo. Keep it classy in my channel. Huh. It's very interesting that this design won't take off. At least we got it spin stabilized and then we ditched the under things and now we're spinning on this. But I still can't take off. I don't have enough lift from all these wings. Huh. Landing gear success. Yeah, I don't have enough lift from these wings. Interestingly, I think it'll be a more controlled experiment if we can. There it goes. Yes, needs even more pitch. Valor, we tried that earlier and it was too much drag. It wasn't any more lift. Need more lift. Too heavy. Yes, longer wings for sure. About half the fuel. Clip wings inside of each other. We won't tell. No, never. It's just not going up very fast, though. It's definitely a Kerbal ceiling fan. This is like perfect for a supervillain. Soon. All right. We have to come up with a scientific style design that we can vary things. We can totally vary things, right? It needs time to spin up, you're right. Struts to the rockets, from the rockets to the upper lowering wings. Are we gonna break the 800 meter mark? More wings, more larger radius, which is bad for the rotation speed. Turn off the SAS. I believe that turning off the SAS may make us die. Maybe not since we're spin stabilized now. I wish there was some way to see what the rate of rotation was. If I had Mountain Dew instead, I believe it would work. Did you really? Yes. 800 was the record. Okay. Yeah. All right. I think we need to go about this to a scientific sort of way of doing things, right? Because we got all the way up to 16 meters per second. This design is worse. We'll try to get past it again, though. It is climbing faster and faster and faster. All right. We need to do this from, like, a scientific sort of perspective. So let's see what we've got. We don't need any of this shenanigans. We can actually just... Look, we can always make this again, okay? Maybe not that piece. Well, we can always make it again. Okay. What we really need to do here... I need a different... Yeah, I want to be able to test things like angle of attack and that sort of stuff. So I'm going to need... I'm going to need something that I can work with here. Look. I am going to put just some sort of internal structural segment. Like this. I don't really like making this like this, though. I need something kind of short and squat. It doesn't weigh very much. One of those nose cones would be good. Use a one-time altitude boost. Nah, I don't want to do that. Bunch of useless weight. I think you're better off with the jet engines. I think you're correct as well. Longer props with a better angle of attack can sustain lower speed and increased airflow. You just tune the booster thrust for speed. All right. I think we're going to go with this, okay? We're going to do that. We're going to get ourselves a fuel tank in the middle. I wonder how... that's probably enough Delta V. Take all the oxidizer out. Oops, that's not oxidizer. Okay, there you go. Right? We'll put that there. We've got the RTG now. Now, we need a mount for the engines, right? What did Hellion say? Longer props with a better angle of attack. I think you guys are wrong on the angle of attack, but I'm willing to give it a try. I have a feeling that more angle of attack is going to mean less lift. It's just my gut feel, but I don't know if that's right. Let's see. Longer wings, he says. Is that it? Nope. Drink! So you want, like, an angle of attack like that, right? And we need jet engines, right? I don't even know what that just said. Makes it harder to spin. Move the mass towards the center and have the wings lighter. It's easier to spin. So you want me to do something like this, and I've already explained the problem with that. You don't have enough room for the engines if you do that. You don't have enough room for the engines. We could try to do it like that, but there's just not enough room for the engines, unfortunately. So, craft rotation value. Oh, actually, signing me, that's a great one. That's a great one. Yeah, the angle of attack on the helicopters is not very big, Thermatius. It's not very big. You can vary the pitch, but whenever it's doing normal flight, the angle of attack is not 45 degrees. It's almost just like that, because the wings are airfoils, right? So, we don't have enough room for the engines if we do that. But I want to do something where I can actually vary this, right? So let's do that. Let's do the basic jet engines, because we don't want to, like, spin ourselves out of control. And this is only going to give us 4. I wish that I had less. I want to go with 6x symmetry for reasons. 3x. Actually, 3x will work. So let's try it with 3x engine. Let's try it with 3x. And then I'm going to put these like this. Watch. And we'll build a big old long wing. Yeah, I got it. That's what I just did. I'm not going to tweak scale. I got it, guys. I got it. Yeah. So that's what you want, right? You want a huge sort of shenanigan-y thing like that. This'll work, though. The wing will be too long. I don't want it to be too long. You have faith. In this way, we'll be able to vary the angle of attack, is what I'm going for. I want to be able to vary the angle of attack. Red underglow. To lift, put control surfaces on the trailing edges of your wing surfaces. I'm almost wondering if that's cheaty. I don't know if that's cheaty or not. I have a feeling that if we don't strut these things in, they're going to fall apart. So I'm just going to try to go for like the Red Baron strutting here. I got to get them to the same segment or that's a weak point. Oops. If I don't get them strutted to the same segment, it's going to be a weak point. So like that, right? Oh, no, I have basically 5-degree increments that I can do. So let's try with this high angle of attack like that, right? Oops. What did I do? Whoa. Okay, so let's try with this. That's not 45 degrees, that's like a 30 degrees. I think the longer wings are going to be killer. So not good. It's not stable at all. That is not a good thing. It's not stable at all. This part, it's just going to rip itself apart. It's not stable. Huh, I wonder why it's not stable. This is amazing. The engines have to cover more distance on the outside. All right. This can't fly straight. I wonder why this can't fly straight. Engines on the end of the spars, I do believe, would be a... It looks like it's coming after me. This is not going to end well. Alright. Lower lift and turbojets to spin faster. Wings are too long. A weighted bottom to act as a keel. 4X will make it more stable. You're probably right that 4X will make it more stable. Launch clap so that the engine spool before takeoff. You need a second counter-rotating. I can't do that one. The entire craft is going to rotate, which is okay. You want the engines you want at the end, so back to the booster design. But just use jet engines. I almost think... Did this just crash my game? This may have just crashed the game. Hang on. But we can't do it. We don't have access to those things in this game. And it's... We had it perfectly stabilized before. I think the game has crashed. Hang on. We're totally frozen. What do y'all see? Huh. It's just stuck. That's not good. What's the stream say? Wow, okay, I don't know what's going on here, but I don't even have a, I'm not going to use any mods. I think that the game has crashed, but I'm not actually getting a crash. Parachutes on the bottom to brute force, but I, that's not the problem. It's tilting to the side. I have never seen a game crash like this before. Something is totally nailed here. Keep the three engines, try for six wings. There are motors in the code of the stock. You need a CSV for a motor. Parachutes have the pesky property of disappearing whenever they want. Alt F4 for not safety. Yeah, the game is like, it's just not responding. What can you do though? I guess, huh? We can always just start this up again. Yeah, no, there wasn't. There wasn't an error underneath. That's the first thing I tried. What's the center of mass? That's a good question. Scraggles McCoon, take it easy. Kapow! Shorten the wings a little. I think the long wings are definitely a problem. Jeeker, good. I think that it's better with the engines on the outside as well. Yeah, they have to go faster and you've got more mass rotating around. Damask, nice. Oh my gosh. Yeah, there was not a message in the background. Take it easy, Drac, and Indy Brown and Dragon Slayer. Guys, I'll take it easy. Do you think it would? The canards were totally going to be kind of doing a... Yes, it does. Come on, because it cheats, break the game. It's worked, Pedro. It's worked. We've got this to work. Because the entire craft is rotating, it's okay. And hey, look, I got the cheat. Hey, check it out. I totally got the Easter egg. The craft can't handle it. I got the Easter egg. Look. Oh my gosh, that Kerbal though. I got the Easter egg. Excellent. We're having fun. I'm still having fun. I think we need less angle of attack, maybe. Post shimmy stream raid. Nice, Joel. Nice. Uh-oh, that's a whole lot of joins at once. Post shimmy stream raid from Joel Flake there. What's going on over there? Did shimmy make it? Did he make it? Now you're racing you. You're racing me? Hey. Oh, I gotta be in the game. Alright. We're not spinning fast enough. We need to spin faster. If we spin faster, it'll spin stabilize before it can lose it like this. If we can spin it faster before we let it go, it'll spin stabilize. The KSP Kraken is now following the channel. Oh my gosh, what is that thing? All right. That wing design is not working. Like a helicopter, make it work. Try putting the engines on the outside. Let me vary a couple other things before I put the engines on the outside. I think these wings are just too long. Yeah, I'm gonna try less angle of attacks. About halfway out. Shimmy's Raid Quest! Uh-oh, what's going on, Shimmy's Raid Quest? At the speed, once you leave the ground, I guess you could lose some wing less. Shimmy's Raid Quest! Oh no, it's Shimmy's Raid Quest! What are we gonna do? Go to 10 degree angle of attack. Shimmy! My space budget is low and I have to use helicopters to get into orbit. I've got to keep it like perfectly straight up. Look at that! See? Okay, there. There you go. That's actually a lot better. It looks like it's going to get off center, though, but it is a lot better. Something about the lower angle of attack. There's no way that I can control this thing. Yeah, pressing the keys is going to do nothing. Pressing the keys is going to do nothing. But see, less angle of attack was a lot better. Less angle of attack was definitely a lot better. That is interesting. Dude, shimmy! What's going on? What a fancy helicopter, says the KSP Kraken. My, that's a fancy helicopter. Would be a shame if there wasn't something for, if something was to happen to it. Whoa! That works. Oh, wait, I got 4K followers? DOS does nothing but fun to watch. Nice, thank you. I need SAS. I had SAS on. I need more SAS? What a fancy blender. Do you think I need more SAS? Shimmy! What's going on? It shows 3999999. Some guy with a beard said to come here. Nice. Where is our center of mass? I bet you. Yeah, I just did it. Boom! Whoa. Kamuchi! What the heck? A cent for every follower. That's, dude, Kamuchi, seriously? Gosh. Oh my gosh. 4K follower hype. $40 donation from Kamuchi. Sent for every follower, says Kamuchi. Dude, Kamuchi, thank you for that. That's amazing. I really do appreciate the support. You were waiting. You were waiting on that, weren't you? You were waiting on that. You were totally waiting on that. You were like, what? Yeah, okay. Huh? You were totally waiting on that. Kamuchi, thank you so much for that. That's like a big deal. That sort of support is a big deal. That is an absolutely big deal. Thank you so much. I really do appreciate the support. I'm gonna keep flying this thing. I'm gonna keep flying. Only 1.5 hours. Nice. Oh my gosh. Yeah, Cybertech, we were talking. It would be nice if we could see the rotation, how quickly our craft is rotation. Oh, pitch on roll readouts. What? Really? Wait, maybe we need to do this. Maybe we need to do this. Look, I'm gonna do some things here. I'm going to try and do some things. I'm going to add a stack decoupler on the bottom. Kamuchi, thank you again, by the way. Move the engines out, it'll work. Jeeker, good. Let me try this first. I am going to put a ballast down here. An additional SAS. I know that it's going to be additional weight. But I want to move my center of lift down below my center of mass, right? I want to move that center of lift down. I wonder if we could angle the wings up. Oh, it doesn't show acceleration or rate, just the position. I see. Cheetah Ben, thanks for the follow. Who else did I get? Snake Maker, E-Train, Nuker Noah, Cheetah Ben, Volkniz, Combat, GLP. Who else? 4,000, my thing shows Bomb Mask, KSP Kraken, Motorhead. 4,009 followers is what it says over there. Dude, use the things that go on the back of the wings. You can get away with less wing length. Would that add more or less control or negate it? Let me see if this works. I need to add a pivot point on the bottom. A strong pivot point. Seems legit. Let's go. Yeah! What's up, dude? Combatant 90. How's it going? Position like the things in the lower left corner. At the rate, it looks like you can get away with those things. We just have to get it even. See, if we start off sideways at all, it's like we need to spin up very, very, very quickly. We need to spin up very, very, very quickly to spin stabilize before we get the lift mosed out like this. Alright. Mater, take it easy, man. I'll clip some things for you later. So putting the center of mass lower does not help us. Jeez. Biggest drill bit in the world. Okay. Putting the center of mass lower does not help us. That did not make any difference whatsoever in terms of stability. And putting more SAS on there. Turbojets? Turbojets would be less. Could we kickstart it? Yeah. Could we kickstart it? Dude, Cy Young Mi, I like that. Could we kickstart it? That's a great idea. We should totally kickstart it with the these thingies. Yeah. Of attaching with the claw and loosening it. That won't work, Joel Flake. That won't work. Put engine in the middle of the wings. I am going to try that next. What does my hat say? My hat doesn't say anything. There's nothing on my hat. All right. Not lower aligned. Wait. DOS. Not lower aligned. Otherwise, you give torque a lever arm. Not lower aligned. Otherwise, you give torque a lever arm. Oh, I think I see what you're saying. Hang on. You want the center of mass to be higher, aligned with the center of lift. Right? That's what you're telling me? Put a vertical fin on the tips of the blades. The Kraken is helping me out. Hang on a second. Yeah, dude. Kamuchi again, thank you. I really do appreciate the support. You gotta put the engines just a tad further out. I'm gonna try that next. The way it was, tore the wings off. You need to strike a balance. I need to spin up fast. I think we know that we need to strike up fast. My hat doesn't say anything. Alright. You saw me grab my hat? No. My hat doesn't say anything. What's wrong with my green screen background all of a sudden? Alright, moving right along. The Orion stream is going nice. Hey, I'm a nice guy. Alright. I think it also helps to be pointing exactly up. Yes. I have a feeling it's going to get out of control because the spin rate is not fast enough. We have too much mass on the outside and we don't have enough lever arm on those things. Did you see how when our spin rate was faster? So if you want a faster spin rate, you need shorter wings. You need shorter wings. I think we need shorter wings. G-Kurgood, I saw it, but I don't want that. I don't want to try that yet. I think the shorter wings is what we need. Shorter wings is what we need. We definitely need shorter wings. So let's half the distance of the wings. We're gonna keep the same wing area. We need a faster spin rate. We definitely need a faster spin rate. What if I just put these on like this, right? We need shorter wings for sure. The answer is going to be shorter wings. And let's see here. Is that going to reach? I think it should, right? Yeah. Okay. Shorter wings is good. We're not getting enough of this. We weren't getting enough shit. No, but I think we're okay. I think we need shorter wings so that we can spin faster, right? More mass on the outside will make us, No, I know. Goober K, I know what's going on. We're trying to fix it, right? We're trying to fix what's going on. So, we need to be exactly straight up and down. A better base would help us with that. What is that strut connected to? So see, that's giving us a faster rate of spin, which is keeping us... What is that strut doing? That doesn't look good. There's a miscellaneous strut just sticking off the craft. It's not looking good at all. Yeah, the wild strut. I don't know, dude. Scar, what's going on? Yeah, I see the wild strut. I don't know what the deal with the wild strut is. So see, we're very spin stabilized. We've got a faster rate of spin, and the problem is it's just not pointing straight up. I'm not liking the strut either. The faster rate of spin, I think, is the way to do it. The strut is the work of the Kraken. Where is that strut originating? I didn't actually see it. Dude, Mike Lanius, what's going on? Yarun, we're trying to work on this. It's the Rufflecopter. Alright. Shimmy with the host. Dude, Shimmy, thank you for the host as well. There are no Kerbals on here. Where is our center of mass? Where is our center of lift? Y'all want me to put the, use more of the little rockets. I actually think that that's going to be the thing. The single wings on the engines. And use more of the little rockets. I think that that is going to be good. Lord Tenchi! What's up? How's it going? We're working on some shenanigans here. That's just one. I really do think that the rate of rotation is what's going to keep us from, the rate of rotation is what's going to keep us sane here. SRBs, we already tried that. That's not a good idea. I think if we, I think, jeez. If we move the engines out further, we're not going to get the same rate of spin. We're not going to get the same rate of spin. Use SAS modules. That wasn't helping us. We already tried more SAS modules. Spin stabilized Rufflecopter. Yes, Yarun, that's exactly what we're doing. Mount the engine assembly. No, no, Nuker Noah, that's not what we want to do. That's not what we want to do. Was SAS active on launch? Yes, it should have been. Alright. And something that would allow me to be exactly level here at launch. I think being exactly level at launch is very, very, very important. Exactly up and exactly level. Let me read the chat in just a second. The engines don't spin up enough when we fire the boosters. And you see how the direction of travel slowly but surely gets off? The more and more that gets away from us. We can't let that get away from us. You'll get the same rotation, you'll get better. Part of the problem is usually jet low to startup. Yeah, you're right. That's why we're kickstarting it. That's why we're kickstarting it. With RCS, more lights, more docking ports, and fashion. I'll try it once. I'll try it once without the SAS on. I will try it once without the SAS on. And I think if we had some way to throttle those engines up sooner. Let me try to light the engines first. That's not good. I didn't catch it in time. Yeah, that's not gonna work at all. We need the, air is spilling off the narrow edge of the wingtip. Launch clamps. Yeah, but launch clamps are killing us. Alright, I caught it that time so I can keep it straight. And I'm going to keep it straight with SAS while the engines spill up. I've got to do like three things at once here. That's slowly but surely going to get off because it's not spinning fast enough again. Ah, I didn't turn SAS off. To spin up the engines, then launch the stage clamp. Yes, Sayoung Mi, I think we could probably do that. Hold it with the red tower, fix the level problem as well. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. And I will try to put the engines further out. I'm just, while I'm in this configuration, I'm trying to fix it. And I will try to put the engines further out. I will do that. I know a lot of people really believe in that. You may be right. You may be right, for sure. Okay. There we go. Yeah, Bombass, I'm gonna turn that off as well. It probably is. It probably is the, Why not use aero spikes? We're trying to use the jet engines. No SAS did improve it, you said. They're engines that spin up faster. The rocket engines would. What other engines spin up faster? Alright. So dart ton on SAS. Just like the jet engines. Let them get to full thrust. That sounds good. There's 100 thrust from the jet engines. There's 120 thrust from the jet engines. I understand I don't have much of a lever arm. There's 130 thrust from the jet engines. There's 140 thrust from the jet engines. Let's try this. But see, now we're not, we seem to be going up at least. Let me get rid of that. That's super annoying. But it's slowly but surely going to get off. It's still not spinning fast enough. Is it? We're already up to 500 feet, but it's getting worse and worse. We gotta spin faster. We have to spin faster. Oh, Rapier engines. Interesting. We are gonna move the engines out. We did not have success with the engines out further earlier, so we moved them in. But it's slowly but surely getting off. Go back to the wheel design, turn the brakes on the start, let them go full thrust. Let's put mainsails on the wingtips. Yeah, we're just not spinning fast enough. Okay, I'll try to move the things out. I will totally try to move the things out. So what, y'all want it like halfway out? Not much improvement. Okay, it's like a wobbling top. Alright, so y'all want the engines further out. They'll have more lever arm, but you'll have more rotational inertia from the mass further out on the wings, right? So you'll have more thrust to deal with, but you're also going to have more mass that you have to move, more rotational inertia, which is going to cost you more energy to get rotating. So let's see how that works. What do y'all want me to do? One or two? All the way out. You want them all the way out. Okay. I'll do it. I will do it. That's what you want, right? Is that what we're doing? Yeah, but that's why I'm saying it. There was a chiptunes thing. One. Halfway out. Wings in the middle. Jeeker good set all the way out. Other people said half the way out. We'll try it. Yeah, we did this before. We did engines all the way out and it didn't work before. It did not work before. I don't think the struts are going to reach. I will put the engines as far out as the struts can reach. Let's say that. Yeah, that doesn't reach. Let's try it like this. Those. Let's give this a try. We'll give it a try, and then we'll do it the other way, right? Because we're also getting steering problems. I'll try halfway. Three halves of the way out. I will try these different things, guys. I will try it. I know some people... Iowa Viking, that's cheating. We don't want to do that. Okay, no SAS. Throttle up. Jet engine spool. It's probably part before we can even get going once they throttle all the way up. It's torquing our entire craft around. We're missing some Separatrons too, apparently. Nope. It just rips the engines off at that rate of spin. Wouldn't it be hilarious if this worked with one freaking engine on it? Oh my gosh. I don't think that should make a big deal. It should. Look at it. It's still going. Watch. This goes to orbit after we just put one freaking engine on there and the ace ability like keeps it. You have to be kidding me that this would work. This one is unbalanced enough that it's staying balanced. It is totally, this is our altitude record so far. It's so unbalanced that it's staying balanced. Oh my gosh. I think there's only one. There's only one engine left. This is amazing that this would work. This is amazing that this would work. Geekergood, I don't think. I think that the reason this is still working. Why does it say there's two engines? There's not two engines left. There's only one engine left. I don't think that it's because of the spin. It's because we've got the washing machine effect. How high is this thing gonna go? Shimmy, we're trying to see if we can get up to a better launching altitude using a helicopter. Now you can steer it. You're right, I can steer it. I don't think I want to steer it, though. We're at 2,500 feet. Oh my gosh. This is nuts that this oh no, we lost our other engine. Quick, eject the Dr. Pepper can. Rotate for orbit. Go, dorsal side, light, SAS, full throttle. No. Where is the thingy? Where did it go? Is that it? Well, there's an engine going off. Oh my gosh. No! No! The launch stabilizer is on the nacelle so they don't take it apart. It works too well! Oh my gosh. Yes, we're just trying to toss together a helicopter launch platform, yes. Alright, so we knew that it wasn't going to be a good plan if we didn't have those struts. So let's just put more struts in here, right? Let's put struts like this, connected to the same piece for sure, in multiple X symmetry. And the same thing on the bottom. Yeah, Shimmy, that is what we're trying to... We're just playing around. I got tweeted by a freaking huge YouTuber earlier who was here hanging out in the channel, and he asked, I was doing help desk, and he asked me the question. It's incredibly unstable. Nice. Yeah, red one, we totally got 4K followers. We're having so much fun. Cy Young Mi, get you some sleep. You're switching to a single engine design. A single engine design. Let's try this. And maybe just for, you know, giggles, we could do this. I really wanted to do it without having struts like that, though. Let's see if we can do it without having struts like that. Because Hank definitely had, like, his looked like a spider web. Alright. Please try it with that thing as weird as it was. Struck the balance I was talking about earlier. Please try it with the engine halfway out. Let me try this one more time, and then I will totally try that one. Switching to the single engine design. What if we just made a big long wing, and we just put an engine on it, and we flipped the entire wing around? Yeah, Hank Green was here earlier. Yeah, it was Hank Green. Tweeted me out to, like, all of his freaking followers and was hanging out in the channel, and this is what we're doing this in honor of, because I totally appreciate what he was doing for me earlier. Yeah, he was the one that asked if we could do this. That's why we're kind of playing around with this. The turbojets may be a good idea. It was the same thing, that's awesome. Yeah. No, he's the one who had us doing that. You don't think I can spin this upright, huh? Let me turn off SAS. Let me give it full pitch. And we should have full jet engine now, right? Yep, 145. That's about as good as we get. Alright. Nope, it rips apart. It rips apart. There's too much mass on the outside. There's too much mass. Paleo, we've already tried that one, Shimmy. We've already tried that one. That one didn't help us out. We tried to put a big counterweight down at the bottom, and that really didn't help us out. We've tried so many things. Yeah, the Hank Green. It was the Hank. Well, the Hank Green. I didn't know who it was. I was like, wait, what? And somebody's like, that's his actual naming channel. And I was like, wait, what? That's his streaming channel? I don't know what to do. It needs two engines less. More struts. I've already got them strutted out the wazoo, though. I've got so many struts on there. It needs two engines less. No, I'm going to try the engines. Recreate the one-wing flute, the wobble stabilized. The wobble stabilized one-wing flute. We were really just, I wonder if we could throttle down. I'm trying to solve it without doing that. One engine wobble death stabilized. Yeah, I didn't even know what to do with it. Let me try less throttle. Yeah, it was totally sweet. It was totally sweet, Slimmy. That's why we're kind of playing around with this. He did the same sort of thing, and now we're just having fun. We did a help desk earlier, answering all sorts of questions. Short side mute. Yes, that is what we're going to try. That is what we're going to try next. I'm just going to try half throttle this time. I'm going to try half throttle. I'm trying not to do it without that. I know, deep in the batter. I'm going to do it. I've strutted to the middle core. I've already done that. I could put more struts on the bottom, I guess. But I'm trying to keep it from strutting like that. That's half thrust. I honestly don't think that this is even going to take off. Angle the engines into the middle of the craft. That's interesting. I think we're going to need full thrust, and then I'm going to have to down thrust it. Don't use chase cam. Alright. Let's see. Wait, we've got a two-engine design going now. A vertical engine. No, we can't put a vertical engine in. It's nuts that the completely unstable design is like the most successful design. Anytime it's completely unstable, that's like the best thing. Let's give it some more throttle. Oh my gosh. It's already above 900 meters. Das, you've made such a beautiful thing. Saiyan, we're trying to make a helicopter launch pad. We're totally trying to make a helicopter launch pad. This is not doing so well. Somebody said not to use chase cam, so of course we've got to use chase cam. It's like bullet time all of a sudden. So this is what it looks like from this perspective. Dude, Saiyan, what's going on, man? We're having so much fun. We're up to 1,600 feet. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, Shimmy, that's exactly my problem with it. That's exactly my problem with putting him out on the end. It's amazing. Look at the wings. Look at the wing segments coming apart. Oh, my gosh. Look at that. Use three engines and decouple two. It's the what? It's the hula hoop principle. That makes sense, actually. That does make sense. Look at that. Oh, no! Drat! Oh, my gosh. Shucks! That is terrible. I love the bullet time mod. We could totally auto-rotate this thing down. All right. Motion sickness, anyone? I'm going to try the wings in the middle. I'm going to try the wings right there. Sorry, the engines right there. So that they have less, right? It's amazing to me that the three-wing design is like the most successful, or the unstable design is the most successful design so far. All right. So now we're strutted like that. Whoa! A single wing with an engine and two big payloads. Yeah, that would actually be great if a Kerbal was on board. Oh my gosh. I'm not even going to click on that right quick. I'm not going to click on that, Spartan. That sounds terrible. I don't want to see what's happening. Oh, we already tried SAS. We already tried SAS. That wasn't a great idea. And I'm trying to do a little bit of a Fashion Academy thingy here and not just put 18 bazillion struts on it, you know? All right. You'll never top. I really want to try... I really want to try one big wing. One big wing. Unless he increased the width of each wing. Yeah, we couldn't... The SAS was not spinning. The drag was overcoming that. The drag was totally overcoming that. That's gonna fall down onto there and then cause us huge problems, right? Is the most effective and therefore succeeds? I don't know that the unstable design would be the most effective. I can see that it would be effective. I don't know if I'd say it would be the most effective design. Let's try it with the engines in the middle. Yeah, dude. Take it easy, dude. Tholomoop. Thanks for the follow, man. I really do appreciate it. The Vomitron 9000. I do appreciate you hanging out with me, Tholo. Thank you so much. I've been having too much fun with this. Every now and then, you just gotta stop with the Space Academy, and you just gotta have some fun, and that's what I'm doing right now. Let's see if this works. Do I have the armory mod? Nah, I don't do that. Well, that's a bit of a drag. That's hilarious. Put on 18 bazillion threats. You have a Dr. Pepper. Yes, I do have a Dr. Pepper. I totally have a Dr. Pepper. I'm trying to take it to space. All right. Here we go. Full cue. What just happened? What did we lose? All right, we lost one wing. We lost a lot of stuff, honestly. A vertical wing on the tip of the blades. This is not... We're still going up. Short side mute. NyQuil 3. Zetlinoak. Zetlinoak, thanks for the follows, Jules. Rotated too fast. Rotated too fast, you're right. Three wings on the sides, but then you can put two more sets on the front. You know what the I think what a big problem here is? I think a huge problem here is strutting to this thing at all. This thing tears off. This is like one of the weakest freaking parts in the game. You know it to be true. Let's just get rid of that stupid part. that part's hilarious, by the way. I am amused by the funsies you are having. Dude, I'm amused as well. We don't even need that in there, I don't think. Let's just get rid of some additional weight, right? Centripetal force OP. The spin is beautiful. Dude, saying the spin is absolutely beautiful. And look, I'll do this. I will strut like this. Not in 1x symmetry, in 3x symmetry. So let's strut like this. Nope, come on. Come on, give me the strut. There you go, strut connector. Oh, that's one that's not even doing anything. Strut connector. Where is it at? There it was. Alright, there it is. Oh, I still have the random blocks as well, huh? And I'll strut to the actual body like that. Now I've got that in 3x symmetry. And I've got these random things. Maybe we could get rid of those. And I don't even think we need these. Too many struts! No! Yeah, I got rid of those. I got rid of those. Make an awesome robot. Probably. Look at these struts. There's just struts everywhere. I am honestly thinking that wings that won't fall apart is going to be the big thing. What's up, Mangles? We're making a helicopter launch pad. We should totally put the Dr. Pepper on top as well. I think the Dr. Pepper on top is going to be a lot better for us. Oh my gosh. Folks, we've got some other streamers in the channel right now. Try to land the Dr. Pepper. That's what I'm doing, Sandy Rose. We've got Saiyan over here. Where's Saiyan at? Where's Saiyan? Where's the last thing Saiyan said? Dude, Saiyan, I totally enjoy watching your stream, man. Where you at? There you go, right there. You might want to toss old Saiyan a follow. Say something down at the bottom of chat, man. Say something down at the bottom. We also had, Shimmy was in here. And then Scarlet River was in here. Shimmy and Scarlet River, dude, if you guys are here, say something in chat. There's Saiyan right there. Oh my gosh, my eye. Oh my gosh, alright. Yeah, it is two layers of blades. It is. But guys, toss some follows over there. Saiyan right there. I totally follow Saiyan. Shimmy's in there. And then Scarlet River's in here. Who else is going on? For the NPCs you deleted. There's Scarlet River. Dude, what's up, Scar? I totally follow Scar as well. Shimmy was here. We've got a couple other streamers. I love to support other streamers, even when I'm doing wacky shenanigans such as this. So, give old Say and Scarlet River and Shimmy follows, guys. They are good people. They are totally good people. Can you put Struts on the leading edge of the wings? Far too kind. Nah, Saiyan. That's not too kind, man. You're too awesome. You totally deserve it. I love your stream. Oh, I'm still here. No, wait, who else is here? No, 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 look. Check it out. Mangles is a streamer. I follow Mangles. Time out, who else? Damask is a streamer. Excellent, Damask is here. Nubius, dude, how do I miss Nubius? I'm just letting this thing fly. It's getting out of balance, though. Nubius, a streamer I follow. There you go. Who else is here? Who else is here? There. Look at all these. Bam, 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 bam. All right. I think I got everybody. Didn't I get everybody? But look, it's becoming... A, the wings are flying off of each other. See the wings disconnecting? Unicorn thoughts are holding those wings together right now. That is totally unicorn thoughts. And we're still getting unstable. We're still getting unstable. We're up to 3,000 feet. Dude, Grey Rook TV is here as well! You're right! Grey Rook TV is here as well. Dude, Grey Rook is a streamer that I follow. Oh my gosh. The mask key, try it again with the less throttle. It's tilting. Yeah, it slowly but surely tilts. I'm almost thinking about that unstable design. I'm really, really, really thinking about that unstable design. Try it with unbreakable joints. No, that's not going to be it. I don't think that's going to be it. Unicorn thoughts are going to keep it. Yeah. This may be the best thing you've ever done. Meters. I said meters. Yep. We are definitely not going to live anymore. If only there was some way to correct this. Hang on a second, y'all. I'm slowing my rate of spin. I'm gonna see if I can't correct my thingy and then spin up again. Right? That may be a thing. Oh my goodness. That's not good at all. Huh. That didn't work. That didn't work at all. In the game, calculating them not joined. We have already tried the reaction wheels. Look at this! Look at this! Look at this! It's like, whatever, bro, I'm out. I'm taking off again. Oh, we just have to have some way. We just have to have some way to do this. Oh my gosh. I am honestly really a big fan of that single wing design. Correct. Not wrecked. Not wrecked yet. There should be a not wrecked yet command. What if I, can I correct? Look, okay. It's very interesting that it's wanting to spin sideways like a propeller. That's very interesting to me. It's like flying around in a circle. Look at it flying in a circle. As it tomahawk chops its way through. What has landed on top of that? I don't remember putting anything there. I wonder if we can use this. I wonder if we can use this. I'm not going to tilt the engines. Try what? You try large weight hang. We already tried that. Short side mute, that didn't help us. That didn't help us. I think the Dr. Pepper on top. Look at this thing. What is it doing? You've made it. So, we've got the tail rotor. We've got the tail rotor piece going here. Are you steering until a launch? Astral Nomad, I may do it. I may do it. What do you think we're going to hit? We're going to hit something. What are we going to hit? You use it to mow down the KSC. I think I've got the VAB. I think I'm going to hit the VAB. Look at this. Get it. Get it. No, I just barely missed the VAB. Even Symmetry. Nuker Noah, we should probably go. We should probably go to 4X Symmetry. I'm coming for you, fuel tanks. Oh, I still got the VAB. Didn't blow up. It's like in those, it's like in the movies where you tilt a helicopter blade and you chase the guys down. I'm gonna hit a giraffe. Vertically placed wingtips. Whoa, there goes Nightbot. All of a sudden. And it was broken. All the links were broken. Oh my gosh, no, some of the links were broken. I don't even know what the deal is. All right. What was I gonna do next? I think we need to put the Dr. Pepper on top. By the way, look who showed up. It's totally Nightbot showing up. So what other ideas did we have? 4X Symmetry? I'll try 4X Symmetry. I will try 4X Symmetry. I want to keep it classy, though. What if we just did 2X Symmetry like that? And then we put these guys on. Like that. What if we just did ceiling fan symmetry like this? Try the one wing design. I'll do that next. 2 minutes in, the wing connector was damaged from exhaust. Oh, really? That's interesting to know. Yeah, that should be okay. You've crashed your KSP. Put Dr. Pepper on top will stop the tilt. Mysterious Mage, we started with the Dr. Pepper on top, and that didn't help. Yes. Yes, Pedro, we know what's going on. Ooh, that's actually interesting. Gimbal should be locked. That's interesting. 8X symmetry. We've already done those things. Just go to NASA TV. Yeah, alright, hang on. Let me just try this. Let me put some struts in and let me try this. Because I just need 2X symmetry here. No, you won't. Go for it, Astral Nomad. Dude, you're fine. What did that hit? That hit something else. Oh, it hit the stupid... Ah! I done borked it. There you go. I clipped it into there. That's not what I wanted to do at all. Okay. Oh, and that one is actually... Ooh, that one is on the shock cone. We don't want that one to be on the shock cone. We want it to be on the actual engine like that. Okay, good. I think struts are part of the answer. We've gotten up to like 5K, haven't we? I think we've gotten a 5K. Alright, that looks good. I've missed a strut. Oh, because I went to 2X symmetry, that's right. I totally went to 2X symmetry, so I've got to fix this. Alright, there we go. And then we've got these things. Yeah, my Nightbot's not very much of a Nazi. Last attempt, wanted to sit about 10 degrees off at the same angle as your angle of attack. I think that's because, it allows the craft to constantly wobble around, averaging out to straight up and down. Interesting. No, I will not get the blah, 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 blah. I will not get the armory mod. That's not really my sort of bag, man. That's not really my bag. Whoa! Text wall of redness. Maybe it's the ship from the movie Contact. The struts they added. No struts. Here's my wacky looking thing. Wow. That thing looks nuts. Next big step. I think it was named. Announcing their chance for manned missions to Mars. And big this morning. Yeah, Albin, we totally done that. We totally were talking about that all day. Absolutely. Did you ever get the bug we used party? Intention for manned missions to Mars. I think, wasn't that the entire Orion program in the first place? I know they were getting a lot of flack from the media today because people are like, dude, NASA, this is just a freaking pod. This is not something that can get us to Mars. It's got a 21-day life. It doesn't have enough time to get the astronauts to Mars. Let's see what we've got with this one, y'all. Do I have the starters? Yes, I do. Okay. Oh, man. Yeah, we've been talking about it. I may... I don't know if I can, because I'm supposed to be doing boot camp this weekend. I definitely intend to be streaming whenever they do the Orion launch, and I may have to take a break. It's coming up in, what, 5 hours? Yeah. You're already sponsored by Dr. Peppers. I'm not sponsored by Dr. Peppers. Go to bed then, that's all good. Bet they have it. Well, yeah, they do. They have mass simulators. They have weight simulators in it. Let's get these things completely throttled up. Yeah, no, it was really freaking cool. And they were getting a lot of flack from the media because you're like, you're talking about this whole Mars thing and all you have is a pod that has a 21 day. Yeah, they were getting so much flack from the media because NASA was maybe or maybe not overblowing the whole Mars piece a little bit, right? And I appreciate that they were doing that, but they were getting a lot of flack from the media. I was like, oh man, that sucks. All right, let's try this. It's going up so far. Shimmy the JJ, we're just going to see how high we can go. But look, it's getting off rotation again. That one we built was perfect. The one we built was perfect. And then this one is less perfect. It's just going to slowly tilt over until it's completely screwed up. Yeah, you can see the wobbles coming. You can see the wobbles coming. You can see them coming. I think we may have to go with an unstable design. I totally think we have to go with an unstable design because that averages it out. I forgot to lock the gimbals. I'll try that. I'll try that setter pivot. I will try that. Lots of changes coming. Yeah, I totally saw that. Try 4 engines. I don't think we need 4 engines. I want to try one with SAS on. Second stage launch. Alright. I'm going to try to fix the gimbals. What about not tilting the wings? Then we won't get any thrusts. Decouple 3 of the wings after it gets going. No, it's just if it's not exactly rotating exactly, it's going to eventually get worse and worse and worse. Did I get your camera? Anubius, yes I did. I've got an entire freaking care package of stuff to deal with. I have so much stuff today. RCS. I am going to try. I am going to... 1 engine. You're almost at 7K? Nice! Are you just strutting it like crazy? And your things are like flying apart? Nice, Jimmy. Dude, that's nice. Do you have the Dr. Pepper thing underneath? 7K. I love these designs coming in. Check out Shimmy. Shimmy's got it up to 7K. Try it with the Dr. Pepper on top. I will try it with the Dr. Pepper on top. That is actually freaking amazing. Let's see here. Oh, it's going to be so annoying to rebuild in Dr. Pepper on top mode. That's okay, though. We can do it. I'm going to need to do that. I'm going to need to do that. I'm going to need to do this. I'm going to need to do that. I'm going to need to do this. This is the way I wanted to do it at first, because I wanted to do it like a launch pad sort of setup, right? We'll put these things on the bottom. That's still going to be our top SAS. This is going to be our bottom SAS. So this one goes here. And this is going to make it a lot more like a launch pad, right? There we go. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm putting the DP on the top. Shimmy, did you do anything special to get rid of... Are you just, like, less throttling? Oh, you don't have the Dr. Pepper. Oh, that's interesting. Huh. Error 404. I got an error on that second link there. Let's try it with this one. And let's also do this. And that's what you've hit. Ooh, nice. You've hit 8.4K. Nice, Devin. Dude, guys, keep it coming. Anybody that wants to play along, go for it. I'm actually going to... Where's my mod? Ah, 7... There it is. Yeah, no, check it out. Look, I can totally do this. I've got the web image viewer. Is the fact that the payload is wobbling... That may make some sense. There's shimmies. Whoa! The payload is wobbling. So maybe what's stabilizing... Here's shimmies. Look, I can totally... Oops. I can totally put it up on the stream. Oh, man, that clicked through, though. So there's shimmies with the wobbly payload. I think the wobbling is what's allowing the payload to happen. That's actually really cool. You should make it start off stable so it can get in the air and then stable so it isn't. Yeah, I agree. I agree. Might cause a wobble. I don't think the SAS should cause it. So there's Shimmy's design right there with the wobbly payload. I was just trying to unwobble my payload. I was totally just trying to unwobble my payload to see if that's going to help me. That's actually interesting. Winglets are the sizzle. You just have the winglets on there. That's so cheaty. Look how cheaty that is. Oh my gosh. I don't know if I'll be able to get everybody's on here. Here's, this is Kuju Man's. Right there. Using the control surfaces instead of the actual wings. Dude, you should get a Cheaty McCheaterson badge for that one. The entire thing exploded. Nice. Here's Delvin's. Let me look at Delvin's. Wow, that is a hugely complicated craft on that one. You've got intakes. Let me get Delvin's on there. The Death Copter. I love this, guys. Anybody who's working on this, go for it. Here is Delvin's. Right like that. View image. I'll put him on the stream. There's Delvin's design. It's really amazing that so many people are working on this. I love it. I love it. That is so freaking cool. Let me try to fly mine. Guys, keep the screenshots coming and that sort of stuff. Getting too off-centered. I think I've got an idea. I've totally got an idea. Just finishing up a mod I'm going to love, really? Alright. Let me try to launch mine right quick. I'm going for a simple approach here. I'm wondering what a very small wingspan design with the Delta wings would look like. More of like a blender sort of design than a ceiling fan design, you know? Being good enough is at 3.5k and rising. Nice. Let's see this. I just tried to put this on top. Let's see how this works. That's so freaking amazing, dude. I love it that so many different people are working on the same, like, wacky problem. KSP is so freaking cool. It is absolutely cool. So I'm getting mine. Are y'all using the turbojets or are you using the other ones? Multitasking. One wing is shorter than the others. Wait, what? One wing is shorter than the others. Huh? I don't know my design. Real protractor. Nice. You can see the wobble come in, though. I wonder how much of a wobble we need in order to keep going straight up. I need to clean my monitor. Real protractor. Dude, that sounds amazing, Cybertech. I can't wait to see that. I cannot wait to get the real protractor. Is it going to be a protractor that just is like a picture of a protractor that goes on the screen? A picture of a protractor that goes on the screen. So this one is going to have the same issue. Putting the Dr. Pepper on top is not going to help us either. Alright, let's try this. Don't get hit by it. Oh no, it got hit by it. Oh my gosh, Games with Hank! There's like 100 people trying this thing. There's seriously like 3 other streamers and I'm working on it. I mean, look at this. Wait a second, dude. We're continually working on it. Dude, Hank, welcome back. We've got so many people working on this. I've got people submitting screenshots to the stream. Cybertech is a modder who's here in the channel. He's got a mod that allows me to put the actual screenshots from other people here on the screen. Uh-oh. Downloading. Ding, 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 ding. There we go. So many people are putting screenshots up, dude. It's so freaking amazing. We've done that we did that at the beginning of the stream, Mysterious Mage. We tried it with the center of mass. We did all sorts of stuff. So many different people. This one was for, oh, now I don't even know who it's from. Guys, post your links up again. Totally post your links up again. There's the real protractor mod. Oh my gosh, stop scratching your screen. Use the real protractor. Dude, Cybertech. I'll check that out in a minute. Let me get a, look, here's Kuju Man's. Let me grab Kuju Man's right quick. This one's just using control surfaces, apparently. So freaking cool, though. So many people. Oh, my goodness. I need a clear. Cybertech, I need a clear button in there. There you go. Here's Kuju Man's design. Shimmy's design is in there, too. Here's a design from Kuju Man. Kuju, you got up to like 7,000 or something. Amazingly, Hank, Dude, amazingly, the most stable design is one that is completely not stable. I had another one in there. Where was Shimmy's? Yeah, here's Shimmy's design. We had one where two of the engines flew off and only one engine stayed. That one flew to 8,000 feet. Here's Shimmy's design. There's like so many people working on this. Anybody, guys, load up KSP. Give this a try. Give me screenshots. You guys are so freaking awesome. We tried landing waves. How do you share the screenshots? Just put it in. Just paste a screenshot in there. Just paste it. Sweet height with the jets. Yeah, that's what we're trying to do. Let's see here. Just press P. Move your mouse angle. It's meters. I said feet. I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. All right. Here's what I'm going to do. This is DOS's idea. Let DOS have a shot here. I am going to put these on in 2x symmetry, right? And I'm going to put a counterweight that's going to unstabilize the craft. Like this. And what I'm actually going to do, dude, Mad Hatter, Brizzy, Matthew Cope, Sad Owls, the ASO2, okay, now I'm all caught up. Good deal. Thanks for the follows, guys. We're having too much fun here. This should probably be illegal. Let's see. I've got that. And what I need to do is separate out these two decouplers. We'll just put that way up there. Separate them. And I'm just going to get rid of one of them. Watch this. I'll hold my beer. There's that. Okay, so I need another stage in here where I just decouple one of those things. And then we go spin cycle mode. We totally go spin cycle mode. The longer the wings, the better the stability. My most stable craft was one where I didn't have any connections on the wings. It looked like a blender. All the wings were attached to the central core. That's the one that got me the highest so far. I don't know. Watch this, though, Hank. You're going to love this. If I have enough lift to take off, I got to let the jet engine spool up. It's working better than any of my space planes. Guys, I will get the... there's one from Limacardia. Hang on. All right, there's one from... Yeah! Whoa, Limacardia! How is that design working, Lima? Tell me how that's working. Let's see how this works. We're going to be balanced at first, and then we're going to be totally unbalanced. Let's hope I take off because of the extra weight. Nope. All right, I didn't have enough. I needed to spin more because of the extra weight. Okay. Oh. The spin couldn't get fast enough to get stable. Interesting, which of us? Interesting, I gotcha. That's right, you're right. We couldn't spin fast enough. A one-engine one. It isn't. What isn't? Easy mode. What is easy mode? We already did that one. Yeah, we did that one at the very beginning. All right, nice. Let me do this. I didn't get enough. I need more separatrons, or I need less weight, probably. You broke the Twitch link. How did you do it? Wait. You just need a kickstart. Yeah, I do need a kickstart. All right. Oh, I can't edit it out here. What am I trying to do? Revert flight to vehicle assembly. Put wheels in a bottom stage. We totally did that, Hank. We totally put the wheels in the bottom stage and we let it spin around. That, I'll do that, dude. I'll totally do that. We were totally doing that earlier. We had, like, this sort of deal. We had some decouplers on these things. Wait, if I don't put it on the wings, I'm never going to be able to match height on this. That's going to be a problem. All right, let's see here. There you go. And we totally put the wheels like this, right? Well, I'll make the gantry thing, and then I'll put it on here. See... 4x symmetry. Oh, I have to do a 2x2. Shucks. Darn and shenanigans. Okay, so there's that. And then these aren't going to be the same height, but I think I can counteract that by putting it out on the end like this, right? Is that straight? It's nowhere near straight. I tell you what. Oh, because I don't have C on. Okay. So if I do that, I should be able to rotate them until they're straight like that. And that probably looks pretty good. I don't know how well that's going to spin. Oh, because they're not nearly at the same trouble. All right, hang on. There we go. And it's at the end of one wing like that, basically. All right, let's try that. What else is going on? You've logged over 270 hours in KSP. Nice, St. Rose Boss. That's amazing. KSP is like a freaking time sink. Cybertech, dude, that is the freaking... Did anybody just see that link? Look, oh, gosh, look at this thing that Cybertech just made. Cybertech, you are a freaking modding machine, man. We asked for this not an hour ago, and you've already made a mod that puts that on the freaking screen? Oh my gosh, look at this thing. Look at this thing. Just drop the bass after lift off. Hey, that's not a bad idea either. That's not a bad idea. Look at this. Look at this thing. Cybertech, dude, you're freaking amazing. I will get this installed the next time I do a play. This is a great visual aid on the screen as well, man. This is going to make it easier for me to demonstrate the ejection angle when you're going for interplanetary burns. Cybertech is freaking amazing. Put a Cybertech link up there, somebody. Can somebody toss a Cybertech link up? That is so freaking cool. Look at that. We've needed that for so long. We do a freaking help desk. We say we need it. And then all of a sudden, Cybertech, like, makes it happen. I don't even know what to say about that. Except Cybertech's amazing. I'll do it. Cybertech. There you go. Bam. Cybertech totally deserves some support because he is so freaking amazing. He does so much for the community. Okay. Oh, look, I'm taking off already. That's interesting. We didn't even need the kickstart. Huh. Well, let's use the kickstart anyways. And then, drink! I got a drink! That's a Cybertech mod right there as well. Alright, I'm feeling nice and stable. When should I... Okay, there it's starting to wobble. Alright, I'm just gonna try. I'm just gonna see what happens. I'm going to decouple my extra stage and go unstable mode. Alright, now I'm totally unstable mode, right? But this is the way that we go up the highest. Completely unstable mode, usually. Look at this. Although it doesn't look like it's working as well this time. Look at that. Look at unstable mode. We're like wobbling around a vertical ascent. We're climbing at 25 meters per second right now. And we're mostly staying up. Dirty Dan, what's going on? Tez613, I missed you as well. I apologize for that. Look at this. Look at this. Mysterious Mage. No, it is, it's precession. It gets worse and worse over time, so it's always stable at the beginning. It's always stable at the beginning. Look at this. Look how far the pieces are spacing out. That's totally a rate of wobble sort of thing. Yeah, look at this. Look at that piece. Oh my gosh, look at that piece way out there. We probably need to strut those things in. Look at it. The unstable. Now we got to a certain height. I think what happens is Kraken's Bane kicks in, and when Kraken's Bane kicks in, it destroys the craft. I think that's the problem with the unstable design. As soon as Kraken's Bane kicks in, we've got serious issues. It's amazing how far apart the pieces are. The pieces are. Look at this, though. I'm up to 27, rising at 25 meters per second. Spin cycle mode is amazing. It looks like an Olympic hammer throw. You're right, it does. We just need less pieces. Look at that. We're actually getting more and more stable the more we spin. Michaelanius, it's just a precession. It gets worse and worse as we go, right? It gets worse and worse as we go. Look at that, though. And I actually need to do this. There, that's what I want to do. We're still going up. We're at 4,000 feet. How are y'all doing? How are y'all doing? It's like nobody's talking in chat anymore. I think everybody's playing the game. Everybody's playing the game. What altitude does Kraken's Bane kick in? I think rifle bullet. Log altitude. Yeah, we're at 4.3. We're slowly but surely climbing. It's going to be hilarious. Think rifle bullet. No, I know that. But it doesn't help us to spin because we start to destabilize because of the way the physics in the game works. I mean, look at this. I'm going almost straight up right now. Would that be because of the lack of air resist? The fact that it gets more stable? I don't know. That's a good question. I wonder if I'm spinning faster and faster. Did something just explode? You're playing XCOM, nice. You mentioned the game, and now everyone has just lost the game. Leaky brains, what's going on, man? Might break 9.8. You or me, I'm up to 5. Everybody, yes. All hail the glory of the rotational launch pad. The really tricky thing... Oh, I'm actually losing some speed as well. I'm losing some rate of climb. Introducing. Oh, interesting. Yeah. I just made 5 in mine. I'm at 5.8 now. You're too glued to watching this. You're in awe. Mobius Prolix, dude. Thank you. It's amazing that this is so... Look how the nav ball is spinning. It's so perfect.